Well, here's my buck from
rifle season, December 2011. Got it back mid-July. I could have had it back sooner. He asked for the antlers earlier, and I just never got them down. But turned out all right. Alan Riker did it. He lives about just a couple miles from me, and he did the other two bucks here. They're my father's bucks, and 6 months had them back. This buck here, Dad shot, probably 5 years ago. Shot it with his bow. I had the buck about 30 yards from me 2 days before he got it. At least I think it was him. But Dad ended up getting him in archery season, and then he got this one 2 or 3 years after antler restrictions started. And he shot it just 500 yards from the house here. So I believe this one scores like 122, and this one scores mid 115, somewhere in there. So he's under 120, I know that. Now all these up here were post point restriction bucks. Dad got this one with his bow here. I'll take them off. That'd have been 1 or 2 years ago he got that one. And then there's 2 8-points that I got, one with the bow, one with a rifle. This one was shot with a rifle. It's probably his biggest one he's ever got. So this one here, or it would have been if it had all the points and stuff, so. Got a bunch of cobwebs on it.
Yeah. Pretty good.
He ran his mouth for years saying he had all the big bucks, and for a while I got to leave this rack. Before I took the rack to the taxidermist, I'd take it back and lay it on his bed and put it on his chair. So, all those years of him making fun, I got a little payback. So we'll show you pre-antler restriction downstairs.
Okay.
This is the kind of stuff we shot pre-antler restriction. That's my first buck with a bow. Video is actually on the channel there. Shane filmed me shoot this deer here. But I'll show you the deer I got the most excited over ever. You're gonna think I'm crazy. Shot that deer with a muzzleloader flintlock, and I don't know, 12 years ago now, 10 years ago. And I was the first guy out of our group of friends to shoot a buck with a flintlock. So. And that's after Christmas. And it used to be you didn't see, if you saw a buck in muzzleloader season, it was a miracle. If you even saw a buck after the first day of rifle season, it was a miracle. And this is what we shot before the antler restriction. Nothing over probably 100 inches down here at all. Not even close to that.
The antler restrictions work.
I like them.
Yes, sir.
There's still people that don't, but here's the biggest buck I shot until antler restrictions.
Biggest buck before antler restrictions.
Yep. He was lucky to make it that far, probably. Around here.
Yeah. We'll go see some more deer now.
Sounds good. Well, we're in the memory room at the Shaffer house. Johnny wanted to come up, and I'm going to show you some of our kills that we got. This buck here, that is my buck that I shot in 2010 with my homemade longbow made by Chad Holm. That's the biggest buck I've ever killed. Second buck with my bow, and I originally wasn't going to get it mounted, but I figured out why not. You can always get them all mounted. But the next two bucks on the wall, these are mine as well. I shot this one right here in 2006 with a rifle, and I shot this one last year with a rifle on our family farm. Actually, I shot them probably about 200 yards apart from each other, so pretty hot spot up there. Don't tell nobody. But then this big laddie right here, this is probably the biggest memory that I'll ever have. My dad shot this buck. I think Johnny scored this at 156, I believe.
Yep.
It has a broken off point there. He never got it fixed,
but it's the biggest buck that's ever been taken on a farm. And the same day, I happened to shoot this little laddie. As you can see, there's pretty there's a pretty good comparison there.
Yeah.
But both of these bucks...
Now, he was aged at...
3.5.
3.5.
That's a 3.5 year old.
So that just goes to show you, there's a 1.5 years.
And there's a 3.5.
Yeah. Put that up beside him again.
Still a tag. They were actually killed out of the same tree stand, believe it or not. I shot this at 7 o'clock in the morning. 7:30 in the morning. This is killed at 9:30 in the morning. Out of the same stand over at our farm. It was unreal. All
right.
But moving down the line, my oldest brother, Dustin Shaffer, he shot this in Pike County, Illinois with an inline muzzleloader. He's pretty proud of that. I think it's 160 buck out there. It's real. As you can see, it's not real wide.
Yeah.
It's high and it's heavy. I mean, it's real heavy. So, and then the next buck down the line, this is my brother, Dustin Shaffer again. He shot this one down over the hill from the house here. A little story there. He called me in the morning. He's like, oh, I hit it way back. I don't want to go get it. I was like, all right, just wait. We'll go get it after work, you know. Get home from work. I was like, all right, let's go look for this thing. We get down there. There's no blood or anything like that. 40 yards, it's piled up. He's centerboard to heart. I mean, he couldn't have made a better shot on it, you know. But
when in doubt, back out.
Yeah, that's true. But, yeah, this is just some of the trophies that we've got. I mean, I've got many more with the rifle and stuff like that. And my other buck with the bow, it's, I believe, up in my room there. It's on a European mount. But we also got some fish mounted there, a couple of palominos. Oh, yeah. That's the one I caught, and then my brother caught those two next to the gun cabin there, kind of tucked away in the corner.
Yes, sir.
But that's what we do, you know. We go after. I don't hunt these trophies or anything like that. It's just kind of luck. As you can see, I mean, with the first day of rifle season, I kill that little 7-point. You know, it don't matter to me. I just get enjoyment out of it. So, but yeah, I just a lot of time with families. I mean, we got family photos over here of us hunting and stuff like that, and it's phenomenal.
Well, this is my first buck that I ever shot. You know, this was before the antler restrictions. This is probably around 2000 when I shot this, and shot with a 243 up there in the pines. And you know, at the time, a 9-point, that was a big buck. You know, I was pretty excited about it. Here, this is last year, I shot this hen with a beard. It's a bearded hen. She's got about a 6.5-inch beard on her. In 2002 was the first year of the antler restrictions. I shot this 7-point with a flintlock in the late season. And it was the second buck, and it was the first time I ever went muzzleloader hunting. So it was unbelievable to shoot a buck like this. And even though the point restrictions, they didn't kick in to really get these big bucks going until the following year. So that was still a pretty decent buck for around here. And then in 2003, I shot an 8-point. And at the time, that was the biggest buck. You could see how the antler restrictions are working in the picture here. You know, my brother and a friend of ours from Pittsburgh, Ron, you know, we call that the Super Bowl year in 2003. You know, and everyone was killing big bucks. 2005, I shot this buck here. I actually saw him in archery season. I saw this side and this. I thought he was a 10. Saw him the very first day of rifle season. He come out like 20 yards away from me. And I shot at him 3 times in the span of, by the time he ran 40 yards, I already had 3 holes in him right behind the shoulder because I just didn't think I hit him. And I was bound and determined to chase him down the rest of the day, so I got out of my stand while he was laying right just within eyesight. And when I pulled him up, he had all this stuff here. He's got these 2 points are about 1.5 inches. He's got a split G2 here. He probably grosses in the high 130s. And then the next year, 2006, this is the biggest buck I ever shot. There's a video. I'll put the link in the video here. You can go watch. Charles is actually behind the camera right now. He actually filmed me. We actually tracked this buck down and found it. But this buck made Pope and Young in 2006. It grossed in the high 130s, around 138, 139. And then the following year, back-to-back Pope and Youngs, I shot this one in 2007. This is the last buck I've shot. and it grossed in the high 130s, just made Pope and Young by a quarter of an inch, and same place up there in the tree stand.
Well, over here at the house, people wanted to see some of the deer that we've been shooting here in Pennsylvania, and just got a couple here we'll show you. That's Bob, if you want to start first.
It's the first buck I ever shot with the bow. Actually, Trevor shot that buck the same day.
We shot them in the first day, I think. And
6 years ago.
Yeah, it's been a while.
That
was my first buck with the bow. I got a coyote I shot. Actually, it was pretty cool that day. It was me, Brock, Shane, and Jason. We was all watching a big hillside. Actually, I shot my bear. And what, you shot at it five times?
Yeah. Was it close?
It was a far shot.
I shot at 270 yards so far. I shot at it twice. I knocked it down on my first shot. I broke its back. Shane shot at it, I believe, three times, and Jason shot at it four times. So it was a pretty expensive coyote, but it's dead now.
How much did it weigh?
I think 37 pounds with that weight. And Shane shot this buck the bow. We got a bunch of trail camera photos of it. He shot that in 2009. This here buck, I shot this buck last year, the rifle, just 200 yards away from the house. I shot this buck my 8th grade year with a rifle. That was a pretty big buck back then. That was, I think, the 3rd or 4th year of the antler restrictions. Shane shot this buck this year with a bow. Actually, this buck here, and then this 10 point, he shot all three of them on camera. The past 3 years, it was the bucks he's killed. Yeah. And this coyote here, it weighed 40 pounds. It don't look like it in the mount. then you got my monster up here. I shot that buck my senior year. Thought it was a lot bigger whenever I shot it. I got talked into mounting it. Now I get made fun of all the time for getting it mounted. And another thing I want to talk about, split brow times around here. I shot this buck. Got some cobwebs in there. I shot this 2 years ago. The split brows. I shot this the rifle. I found this shed. If you look at these are different buck, obviously. I just found this one this past fall.
Spring.
Spring.
Springtime.
And we got a couple other sheds here. Well, this one here's got a split brow. Oh, it's a pretty big split brow. These are all from right around the area here. This buck here has a split brow. I don't know what happened to this one.
Yeah.
It's a heavy one there.
Yep. Then if we had this in one other video from a shed hunt video, so put the link in the video. Should be on the screen right now. Just click it and you can hear Trevor talk about this shed a little bit more.
Here's another split brow buck. Shane shot this the same year I shot that 8-point with the rifle. Another pretty nice buck. Let's leave that one back.
Yeah. Let that one go.
This upcoming archery, I don't know. This is going to be my hunting arrow. This is a gold tip arrow. That's a 100 grain shuttle T-lock broadhead. And I'm shooting a green Luminoc for you viewers that like to see the impact. Hopefully I put it to good use.
That's where you were using the shuttle T on the run and deer video.
Yes, that's all the videos that you see me shoot deer online, it's the shuttle T-lock broadhead.
Even the groundhogs.
Even the groundhogs. the goose video, it's going to be up here soon. Actually, might be shooting some more geese tonight at the bow. I think I'm back as there last night.
Yeah, we'll put another link in the video with the goose shot with the bow and arrow.
It's the trophy room.
Yeah.
I just need to add a couple more trophies here.
Yeah, I see that.
This is the first bear I ever shot. She was an adult sow, weighed 95 pounds. Been hunting bear since my 8th grade year. Had it figured out. I shot that bear in my 17th day of rifle hunting, not including archery season. You know, with the bow too for bear. Shot her with a 300 Ultra Mag. It was 230 yards away. And
pretty nice.
This is the first buck I've ever shot and killed in my entire life.
I know, it was whenever I was 23 or 24 years old. After years of having the worst luck in the world, I got lucky one day and had a monster 10-point come under. I was super excited, but this is my first buck I ever shot. Worthy of putting him on the wall. I actually won a free mount out of him in a competition, and he's gross. His gross is 131, so he's not too bad. This is the one from last year, my 10-point. He turned out really nice. I'm really happy with the way he looks, and couldn't be happier. And this buck, you know, might not be the world's biggest buck, but it changed my life in so many different ways, from just the luckiness of a guy I know wanted to see the rack, so I took it to a hunting camp, and his daughter was there. I met his daughter, and ever since then we hit it off, and we're actually engaged now to be married next year. So, you know, I'm pretty happy, and I'll always remember this buck for that fact of the matter.
But, so there is good in hunting.
Yeah, there is good in hunting. And this is my turkey that I've mounted, and this one was pretty awesome, the hunt we had. And it's actually one of the main reasons why we jumped onto carrying cameras. Me and Johnny and our buddy went out, and I think it was in 2008 or 2009. It was May 19th, and we went out, and we just had a morning hunt with no luck, and we moved up and heard some gobbles, and we chased after some jakes, but we weren't able to get it. We wanted a triple on them, but we couldn't. And we heard one gobble pretty far away when we were calling with the hen. And then, sure enough, he come running in. But it was just kind of cool because he's in a full strut. And we all, you know, come right out the road for all three of us to see. And that's where I remember Johnny saying right after, he's like, "Man, I wish I had my camera with me." And ever since then, he's carried a camera with him.
Yeah. That was your first long beard, huh, too?
Yeah, that was my first long beard, too.
Awesome.
All right, this is my 2010 buck that we have a video of that Shane Reed filmed. I forget exactly what he scored now. Do you remember, John?
I think it was like 138. Yeah.
138 and an eighth or 3/8 or something like that. I still think it's bigger than Hunter's buck that he shot last year. we'll just have to find out at a later date. Yes, the mount turned out good. Not too much to say about it. I mean, the video is online if you want to check it out. If you've never seen it before, it's a pretty good video. It was a pretty far shot, like a 300-yard shot. That's my biggest buck to date. I'd like to say different about shooting a bigger one this year, but I'm already done for the season. Yeah. It's down in the garage. And it ain't that big. But we'll scare it down the line here. I just got a few of my racks. This is a shed I found, I'm going to say, about 4 or 5 years ago. I was turkey hunting, and there was a buck running around the area with double drop tines. I mean, both sides were exactly the same. And as you can see, it wasn't a giant buck. It just had awesome drop tines on it. And someone actually shot it in archery season and wounded it, but it survived. The buck was seen after the late muzzleloader season. So it wasn't a fatal shot. He made it all the way through. I never heard of anyone seeing it after that. There was rumor of people seeing it the year after, but then no one's heard of it since. So that is a shed from it the year after.
And I actually have
video,
a short clip from an old video of this buck. And you find the shed down where you shot your buck this year.
Yeah.
I'll put a link in the video here. You'll see it probably pop up beside Jason's head there. And you can click that to see the actual video of what that deer looked like. We were spotting, got a little bit of video there with that. And yeah, that awesome, awesome shed.
And I found this shed. I was just walking through the woods turkey hunting, like I said. And you probably can't see it, but the rest of it is really brown and gross looking. Except for his drop tine, because this was the only thing sticking out of the ground. It was buried like that, and I seen a tine sticking out of the ground, and I grabbed it, and it just kept coming.
Oh, man.
And that's what it was. So. And the next buck here, got a European mount that I did myself, is probably the most unique buck I have ever seen personally. It's a funny story. We used to do a deer competition between me, Shane, Hunter, the Dags, everybody, Ryan, Brock, and this actually won it. I believe me and Shane were on a team this year, and this won it for me and Shane, because the bucks we just scored by its width and time points. Well, this just so happens to be a 19 and a half inch wide, 11 point.
Doesn't look like it.
It doesn't look like it. And this actually won for us, and everyone was pretty upset about it because obviously it is one of the scrubbiest bucks I've ever seen. And at first glance, you might think, oh, its tines are busted. No, there's one tine busted right there, and that tine, generously, was probably 3 inches long.
Yeah.
But 19 and a half inch, 11 point. I actually shot this buck the same place I shot that one, probably 2 or 3 years before. So I don't think they're related.
No.
But yeah, that's definitely, that buck has the most character I've ever seen. Then we're gonna move on down here to my bear. I would have shot this in 2009, when I first got home from California for the first time. We all got together and went bear hunting, and I shot this on the second day. There was a group of us went out, and I was actually one of the drivers, and this is a female, so there was a mom and two cubs that got through the drive, and I believe every single one of the watchers got a shot at all three of them, didn't hit them, and they came back through. I shot her, and one of the other guys shot one of her cubs, and the cub, I think the cub weighed 101.
That's pretty big.
On the hoof, or on the pad, I guess you could say, and she weighed 233 or 235. The certificate is upstairs. I keep meaning to do bring it down here and set it down.
Yeah,
but, yeah, 235 live weight.
All right, this is my buck from this year, 2012. Johnny came over today. He's running the camera. He came over to score this for me. We just got done scoring it, and gross, it's about 130 inches. After deduction, it's down around 120, but still really happy with it. I wanted to shoot a 130-inch deer this year. That was the goal I had going in, and all things considered, that's what we did. So I'm happy with that, and just wanted to go through some of the other buck I've shot over the years. These are my best bucks since I started hunting, and the last few years here I've gotten a little more serious about trying to shoot nicer deer. But this was a rifle buck. I'm thinking like 2006 or 7. I can't remember the year I shot it for sure. It's in the 120-inch area. This is my first ever buck with a bow. This is my fifth year archery hunting. So I shot this deer 2009. Same week as I shot this deer, 2009. And this deer is from 2010. And it's also in 120-inch area. So I've had a good run